In this episode of Management Board Unplugged, we're in Globe House in London, talking to Zafar Khan, BAT's Group Operations Director, and Kingsley Wheaton, Chief Marketing Officer. Your hosts today are Anna Mitchell, the Global Head of Business Communications and Sustainability, and Charlotte Packer, an Operations Global Graduate in Global Leaf. We're talking about sustainability before we get a snapshot of BAT's global sustainability efforts. We then chat with Sam Chandrasiri, the Group Head of HR Marketing and R&D, Tania Legkun, the Marketing Director of the Northwest Europe area, and joining us from South Africa is Simon Brown, the Group Head of Operations, Development and Sustainability. They'll tell us about our ESG commitments and how it helps BAT deliver a better tomorrow. So let's get started.
I've been really impressed here at BAT about how ingrained sustainability actions are in the business. But how, Kingsley, this might be a question for you. How can we drive sustainability in its broadest sense across what is a controversial industry?
I think it's hugely important, Anna, and you know, you touched on one of the, for me, one of the key points. You know, because we are a controversial industry, I think it only ups the ante for us in terms of how we have to deliver and perform across sustainability and in our ESG metrics. We have to take governance very seriously. Diversity and inclusion is hugely important, but mostly is seek to transform the business as we go forward and to transition our revenue streams from our sort of, you know, combustible portfolio that comes with the risks and the harm that we understand, and move that to a progressive new portfolio of non-combustible products. And that's all part of the sort of sustainable transformation journey of BAT.
So far, BAT's had a long-standing commitment to sustainability. We've been reporting our progress for 20 years now, but how long has sustainability been a core part of BAT's business?
I think it's been there all along. It's our commitment to our farmers. It's our commitment to our employees. It's our commitment to our suppliers and everything in between. We've now had to expand massively to the entire value chain all the way to scope 3. Not only on carbon emissions, but on recycling, on every single element of sustainability. So bridging all those gaps is what has brought it to real focus.
Kingsley, what would you say the key pillars of our ESG agenda are, and what do these help the business to deliver?
Well, at the heart of it, you know, our ESG agenda is about delivering value to multiple stakeholders. Mm-hmm. So to shareholders, of course, investors in our business, to our consumers, hugely important. And we run programs all over the world. You know, Bangladesh would be a wonderful example where we have an enormous reforestation program going on. It's a multi-year program. And actually, you know, a country nearby, Sri Lanka, has made huge investments over many, many years in CSR and investing in the community. So those are really, really important. And our metrics and our glide path to achieve those are absolutely critical. But I think kind of above that, if you like, almost as the sort of sine qua non of our sustainability strategies, how do we transform BAT? How do we go from a business that defines itself not by the product we sell, i.e. tobacco, but to the consumer needs that we meet? How do we transition from a company that's about tobacco to a company that's about technology? And in so doing, we will change our portfolio, we'll transform our revenue streams from combustible products that cause the harm to a progressive new portfolio of products and actually, most importantly, brands of the future. Brands for consumers of the future, which are both responsible, sustainable, and change BAT forever.
And Zafar, how can we help our farmers diversify and have a sustainable future in terms of different types of crops in their business?
I think that's a great question, because in the developing world, it becomes even more important from a security of food supply perspective, from a livelihood perspective of the suppliers, of the farmers particularly. So that's where we diversify them into and help them into multiple crops. So it's in a country like Bangladesh, we have a 2.3 to 2.4 times crop circulation, which means one piece of land generates 2.4 crops a year, which is massive. That's beyond our tobacco space. The second one, which is very, very important, we've ventured massively into the hybridization program, where we've developed tobacco seeds internally through our own R&D, And that has now covered 50% of our total global leaf production, which has a 20% plus improvement in yields. So the same piece of land generates 20% more income to them. So things of that sort. The third one I would say is our expert programs, where we give inputs to farmers across the world for best agriculture practices. So if you look at our yields as a tobacco crop across the world, we are amongst the top in the world if you compare us to any other crop. So all these inputs have really upped farmer livelihood, and which we continue to support.
Okay, so it's increased efficiency. And going back to the 2.4, so does that mean that on average farmers will grow between at least one, maybe two other crops as well as tobacco on their land?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. And we help them in that space.
Kingsley, we're going into reporting period at the moment, where we're reaching out into the business and collecting and measuring all the data that we were talking about against our targets and so on. And in terms of where sustainability sits at BAT, it reports up through the marketing line. Why is that? Why does that make sense for us as a business?
I think it's a signal. Marketing is about growth. The marketeers have to be at the arrowhead of growing this organization. I think it would be a signal that sustainability is absolutely entwined with BAT's growth agenda. That's why it's part of marketing.
Yep, that makes sense. And I think the way it has to work is it has to be ingrained across the entire business,
absolutely,
which it absolutely
right.
is here. And as I've said, it's very impressive at how much everyone owns the sustainability agenda, but having it linked to purpose and across the, you know, as part of what we are as a business, is it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, there has to be a kind of organizational focal point, and I suppose that's what you and I are in terms of sustainability and business communication across the business. But you know, it's a bit like so many things. The actual efforts of ESG are integrated right across the business. And I suppose that's why Zafar and I are here today, talking on management board Unplugged. But it is integrated right across the business. And so there are no bright lines where ESG starts and stops. It's everywhere.
Exactly. It's enterprise wide.
Thank you, everyone, for joining us today.
Thank you. It's been really great. Thank you very much.
Wonderful to be here. I really enjoyed that.
Our purpose at BAT is very clear, and that is to build a better tomorrow. That's about reducing the health impact of our business. And of course, as we strive to build a sustainable business underpinned by ESG, it's really, really important that we continue to raise the bar of our ESG efforts and place that front and center in everything that we do.
So welcome back, everybody. I'm now joined by Tania.
Really glad to be here.
By Sam as well.
Hi, really looking forward to the session.
And from our South Africa office, Simon.
Hi, super happy to be with you.
ESG, or environment, social and governance, is much broader than a lot of people think. So we'd like some examples of what we're doing in each of the areas. What's operations doing in the ESG space generally?
Yeah, a whole ton of stuff. I mean, it's super exciting place to be working in at the moment. I mean, lots of stuff that we're working on in terms of climate change, reducing the amount of energy that we're using, bringing in new green energy sourcing, things like solar power and wind farms, reducing the amount of energy that we use within our fleets. So those are the vehicles that we use. Also on natural resources, so trying to reduce things like water. You know, the amount of water that we use within our process, the amount of water that our farmers use. We use things like drip feeding irrigation with our farmers rather than just flooding the fields with water. And also things like waste. You know, what we're trying to do is make ourselves more efficient so we generate less waste. But in the waste that we do generate, we want it to be recyclable. So things like zero waste to landfill, super important for us. So lots and lots of great, great projects that we're working on within operations.
There's definitely a lot going on. And Sam, what about in the HR and people agenda? What's happening with ESG in HR?
I think people immediately connect to the E of ESG, but you know, the work that we do in HR is directly related to the S and the G parts. Diversity and inclusion is one of the key areas that spring to mind. We'll talk more about that later as well. But even things like ensuring that our employment practices and principles are really world class, and that we are not only meeting our minimum obligations, but really trying to exceed them. So, you know, the people that BAT employs around the world, they really feel valued. They feel like they're part of a team. They can be productive and engaged. I think this is a really key part of our sustainability strategy.
Thanks, Sam. That's really interesting. And Tania, what's happening in marketing in ESG?
In Unwea, it's a standing alone work stream as part of our strategic leadership agenda, involving cross-functional champions and a diverse portfolio of initiatives. And I also think it's not a sprint marathon. It's great to have very ambitious targets and stay committed to these ambitious targets, but it's very important to deliver and celebrate small milestones. That's how we make it credible and tangible for our consumers. I have some great examples. Cut the wrap project on views when we removed silicone tips from our ports and a plastic film from our packaging. So we made a significant step forward in terms of sustainability and waste management and use of single-use plastic. In modern oral, for example, we are moving to fully recyclable packaging already by end of the year across all our markets.
That's great. And what's the product lifecycle management? Super important. So it's great to hear some of that detail.
Simon, obviously sustainability is massively important in all areas of the business, but how do we make sure we're driving sustainability through our entire supply chain and across the whole product lifecycle as well?
So in terms of driving this across the supply chain, I like to think about the whole value chain. So if we talk about things like when we design our product from R&D and through the product development side of things, to thinking about the circular economy as we bring that into the design of the product. And then across the rest of the value chain, it's about setting ourselves really, really stretching targets. Things like we're going to be carbon neutral by 2050. Things like we're going to reduce 35% of our water consumption by 2025. These are things that set ourselves the targets where we want to go to, the bold ambitions. And with anything in BAT, whenever we set ourselves strong and bold targets, they're the things that we achieve.
We spend a lot of time measuring and tracking our progress across the different areas of ESG. And Sam, this is a question for you. We've been included in the really prestigious Dow Jones Sustainability Index for 19 years. What are some examples of parts, areas of the business where you've worked, where we've been involved in the Dow Jones indice for that long?
I think it's a brilliant achievement. And this is something that does not happen overnight. It's only happening because BAT has been really focused on ESG and also, you know, really working on the topic long before it became a buzzword, so to speak. So I joined BAT 21 years ago, a long time, back in Sri Lanka, where I'm from, where we have leaf growing operations. And even 20 years ago, BAT was doing some amazing work with our farmers on sustainable agricultural practices and improving farmer livelihoods and also supporting rural communities, you know, to become self-sustainable. So these are the kind of things that I think has made us get noticed. And BAT has also pioneered things like our international marketing principles, you know, long before it became a norm in the industry. Coupled with our future focus really on, you know, reducing the health impact of our business, I think we are really making great strides in sustainability. And I was especially proud actually this time that we got top marks, 100% score, I think, in 7 categories. And that included a lot of HR-related things like labor practices, human capital development, and talent attraction and retention.
Yeah, it's a big amount of work over a long period of time across the business.
Yeah, that's really, really great to hear. Sam, also, what other awards have BAT received for their approach to sustainability?
Oh, that there are so many. I don't think we can talk about them all, but to name just a few, we were recognized by the Top Employers Institute as being one of the global top employers, and we were one of the only 16 global companies to be recognized.
Wow, that's fantastic.
It's amazing. And also, I think Financial Times recognized us as a diversity leader. And our US business, Reynolds American, was recognized by the Human Rights Campaign Foundation as being a best place to work for LGBTQ equality.
That's really, really brilliant.
Great. Well, look, thanks so much, everybody. It was really great to see you here today and to be together. And Simon, we're looking forward to seeing you up here in sunny London at some point. What are you going to miss about South Africa?
Well, you used the right words there. The sunny weather in South Africa, I'm not looking forward to coming back in the middle of winter to London, but I'm super looking forward to coming back and being part of the team.
Great. It'll do you good, I'm sure. Thanks so much for being here. It's been really good to catch up with you properly.
Thank you. That was a really good discussion. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you so much to everyone for joining us for today's episode. You can, of course, watch all of our previous episodes on BAT's social channels, on YouTube, on LinkedIn, and on our careers website. Make sure you tune in for the next episode of Management Board Unplugged.